Hey friends, and welcome back to another video. This time I'm doing a net worth update and also an update on my financial goals because a lot has changed over the past couple of months when I first set my financial goals at the beginning of the year. As you know, I have quit my job in order to focus more time and energy on this YouTube channel that I really just enjoy so much. But sadly, since I did quit my job, it will set me back in my financial journey. But you know what? That is okay, because if there's anything that I've learned about money, it's that money should be able to give us the freedom to pursue the things that we really want to do in life and to really pursue our passions. So yes, in the short term, I probably will be losing quite a bit of money. My net worth probably won't be growing very much. But I hope in the long term, this will be a good decision for me to do. And I think that if I am just following my heart and my passions regardless, I won't look back on my life and regret it, even if it might be a mistake. So our net worth is currently $418,239.52, to be really, really precise. Watch out, Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos. Pablo and I are coming after you, even though we might need about $166 billion to get there. But you know what? We're on our way. We're getting there. We're increasing our income. Who knows where we'll be in a couple of years' time? Maybe we'll get to Mars before Elon Musk does. We never really know. In all seriousness, this is our net worth. And while we're not ballers or anything, it is nice to be able to have that money so that we do have the freedom to kind of pick and choose what we do in our life. And this has given me the freedom to be able to quit my job and focus on the YouTube channel because we have built up quite a substantial net worth. We do have quite a lot of money in cash, and this can act as a bit of a safety net while I do try to figure out what I'm doing with this YouTube channel and hopefully try to increase the quality and the value that I'm giving you guys in these YouTube videos. So we'll see where this goes. So these are the areas that make up our net worth. So in home equity, we currently have $139,662.08. So we've actually refinanced our home and we've been able to take out the additional equity in our home to invest in the stock market. And the reason why we've decided to do this instead of trying to pay down our mortgage as quick as possible is because, well, essentially the Sydney property market has increased quite a lot over the past 2 years since we did buy our home. So we have built up quite a bit of equity in our property, just with the property prices going up. And since interest rates are pretty low at the moment we only pay about 2.25% on our variable interest rate, whereas we think that we can get returns on the stock market from 10 to 15%. So that's the reason why we've decided to withdraw some of our equity from our property to invest in the stock market. So I hope that does give you a bit more clarity about the reasons why we've decided to do this. And I will be having another video coming out which goes into more detail about using home equity to invest in stocks. So make sure you like and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on that video. So the next portion of our net worth is in stocks, and we currently have $178,579.87. Most of our investments are currently with ETFs and individual stocks. And we currently use ShareSite to track our stock market portfolio and the returns that we've made, and also produce tax reports so that we can send it off to our accountant. And if you would like to check out ShareSite for yourself, I've got a link in my description below. And if you sign up using my link, you'll get an extra month for free on the Pro plan. But you actually don't really need the Pro plan in order to use ShareSite, because it is free for up to 10 holdings, which is really cool. The next portion of our net worth is in cash, which is $21,741.81. So we actually have our cash in a few different places. We have some cash in our savings account. So both Pablo and I have some savings in our 86400 bank account. We also have a Westpac Life account. And Pablo and I have transferred our emergency fund into this Westpac Life account, which is about $12,000. And the reason why we've decided to do this is because Westpac has a really, really good interest rate going at the moment. At the moment, it is 3%, which is amazing. And it's pretty much the best interest rate that I've seen on any other bank accounts. And we also have a business account with ANZ, and we currently have $4,000 in there. Currently, we do have a debt in our credit card, but it's not an overdue debt, so we're not paying any interest on it, but currently that debt is $3,213.14. So I did want to include that in the net worth, and that's the reason why it's 21,741 $41.81. But you know us, we will be paying off that credit card debt on time. Also, our crypto portfolio has absolutely been taking off lately. We currently have $11,953.51 in our crypto portfolio, and we currently have Bitcoin and Ethereum. We invested $5,000 back in August last year, and currently our portfolio has more than doubled, which is just crazy to me. This crypto bull run is absolutely insane. And speaking of crypto going to the moon, I would really appreciate it if you could tap the like button to help send this video to the moon as well, just like Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. And subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I make videos about investing and personal finance. And the final portion of our net worth is our superannuation, and we currently have $66,302.25. Funny story about this, but Pablo and I actually have pretty much identical superannuation numbers. So I have $33,241.39, and Pablo has $33,059.86. I think it's really funny that we pretty much have identical superannuation balances. Who knew? Well, obviously I knew, because I'm obsessed with tracking our net worth and having a look at how it's growing over the years. So I did know that it was identical, but just wanted to share that with you. The superannuation fund that Pablo and I are currently with is Host Plus, and we were on the balanced option a couple of months ago, but we've recently changed to the high growth option. And the reason why is because Pablo and I realized that we will be investing for at least another 30 years, so we can take on a bit of risk in our superannuation account. Host Plus does have a pretty good track record with superannuation, so that's the reason why we've decided to stay with Host Plus. So when you add all of these numbers up, and don't worry, I did the maths for you. Here is something I prepared earlier. We do have $418,239.52, which is an increase of $21,829.93 from the past 2 months, which I'm really, really happy about. But like I said earlier, since I have left my job in order to focus on this YouTube channel, well, sadly, I think that the next time we do a net worth update, it's not going to really move the needle that much since I have left my job. But honestly, I'm so happy that I did make this decision, and I've decided to take a bit of risk in my life and see how this all pans out. Another update that I wanted to give you is our investment property hunting. So earlier this year, we did want to purchase an investment property. However, we have decided to not go ahead with purchasing an investment property. The first reason is the Sydney property market is absolutely so hot right now, which is awesome if you're a seller looking to sell your property to a bunch of willing buyers. But when you are looking to buy a property, well, it actually is pretty competitive right now. And we thought that we would be able to buy a property in the area that we wanted for about $1 million. But lately we've been going to some auctions, and those properties are selling for about $1.5 million, which is pretty far out of our budget. And another reason is because I've gone full time on this YouTube channel, and this is something that I've personally really wanted to do and something that really makes me happy and motivated, but it doesn't really put me in a good financial position to be taking on another mortgage, obviously. And the third reason is that property investing is almost like having another side hustle or another business. It takes up a lot of time going to open houses on the weekend, so we just don't really have the time at the moment, especially now that I'm trying to dedicate more time and energy to this YouTube channel. So honestly, I'm pretty sad about it, because it would have been really nice to have an investment property, but you know what they say, when one door closes, another one opens. And I know that I am following my heart and my passions and the things that I really want to do in life. So I think I am doing the right thing by following my dreams and my passions. So that is an update on our current net worth and also our financial goals and the changes in our financial situation. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did like this video, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos about investing and personal finance. I'll see you in the next video. Bye! And if you'd like to see some more videos, I've got some links to some videos here, so make sure you click the links and click through to another video.